for those of you who are on, just want to say, I know we promised Vicky would be here today, but she had another training that was scheduled today.
She double booked herself.
Yeah, she's very, very popular. Yeah. But we do have Brunel Callahan with us this morning, and she is the contract administration
coordinator for Alabama.
And she has a history with public housing. So I'm going to scoot in some more.
This chair is really heavy.
They are heavy.
Maybe I can help.
Yeah, this isn't the camera that we usually use, but it works. So I'm hoping that y'all can hear us. If you can't, let us know.
We're having to improvise a little bit.
So. Yeah, we are having to improvise. Not a little bit, but a lot.
A lot.
A lot. Yeah. So we're waiting for a couple of people to log on. Get your questions ready. We're going to talk about body language today. And I have a funny story. Last night, we have people painting in our house right now. Oh, he needs to get in. Hold on.
We're sorry. We have someone at the door. Just a moment.
That's okay.
No problem.
Oh, you're fine.
You're fine.
We have people painting the house right now, so we had to take down our entertainment center last night. It's really a two-man job, but it was me and my husband. And so I'm sitting here holding it while he's trying to unscrew the thing because I wasn't strong enough to hold the drill. And so I forget what he said to me, but I looked at him like this. I was like,
whoa.
And he just started laughing. Says, your face right now. He's like, I'm sorry. But that's hilarious.
Yeah.
So we're talking about body language, how you carry yourself, how you look at people really counts, especially in a situation where people are trying to get housing and you have to get all the right information from them. So we're going to talk about that in, let's say, maybe another 2 minutes. At 9:10 we'll start. But we want to hear your questions as well. So, or see your questions, not hear them. So, have your colleagues log on, let them know that we're live right now, and we'll be getting started in about a minute. How about
Sounds
that?
Good. Sounds good.
Oh, man.
I think this is going to be great because it's really important because it's first impressions, you know?
Mean a lot.
They mean a lot.
And then
they mean a lot.
Sometimes people come in with preconceived notions because they've had dealings with other managers or properties before.
Yes.
So it's very important how you carry yourself, especially if you're trying to get information. Okay, but now I have to get you in here. There you go. There you go. Okay, it's almost.
You didn't have to do that.
Oh.
I was good over on the other side.
We want to include everybody. For the three people who are on right now, can you hear us okay? Is the sound okay? If you could, type yes, no, maybe. Yeah, this was last second. Try to do this on the... Aww.
Hi, Lamar and Pam. How are you? I do miss you.
Hi, Lamar.
I miss you so much.
Thanks, Teresa. Thank you very much. Okay, it's 9:10.
Thanks for joining, y'all.
Yeah,
yes,
really.
Yes, Lamar, I do miss you. I miss you both.
So we're talking about body language today. And as we said earlier, Miss Vicky, was supposed to be here, but she double booked herself because she's so popular. And we have Brunel Callahan, who is our contract administration coordinator for Alabama.
Yes.
So she has a history and experience with public housing. It's actually where you started, right? In public housing?
Yes.
And now she's doing multifamily, and she sees a lot because she does MORs and all that good stuff.
Yes, we do. We really do. And we do make a point of, and a lot of times your communication with your residents is sometimes reported to us in a resident complaint.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we get that a lot. The manager doesn't like me. She looks at me funny all the time. She's talking down to me. I think this is a really good session to give you all some good tips on how not to have a resident feel that you're, you know, talking down to them or disrespecting them in some way just by the way you look. Because, you know, sometimes we can give those looks and they can be misconstrued as being disrespectful, and we don't want to do that.
I know you look at a lot of files because of the MORs, and so a lot of time information may be missing because the interview didn't go as well as it should have.
Yes. And sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes that's because managers get in a hurry. They have so many different things going on, and they, you know, not taking the time to go through all the questions to make sure all the questions are answered. Had an experience with the manager once when the police arrived on the property. Probation officer arrived at the property, and the manager came out, and she's like, "Why are you here?" And I'm here to see my client. He's on parole. And so when she met with the resident, she said, "Your parole officer was here today?" And he's like, "Yeah, I'm on parole. I put it on my application." But she didn't read the entire application, so she missed it.
Yeah, she missed it.
Yeah, she missed it.
And a lot of times we miss body language cues.
Yeah.
You may be talking to an applicant and they may have a confused face. So what could that mean if they are looking like, okay?
Confused face could mean a couple of things. They could be thinking, "Please hurry this up. I need to get this over with because I just need a place to live." Or they could not understand the question. So my suggestion would be to, when you see that, maybe repeat that question and elaborate.
Yes.
If it's if you've given them a questionnaire and it asks that they complete all of their monthly responsibilities, because you're trying to get a grasp on what type of income is coming into the household, and they look at something like, "Why she asked me that?" Explain to them, "You know, we know you don't have income, but these are some of the things that we ask so that you can understand what items are actually considered to be income."
And if you look back on the interview series, we also talk about how you can explain that you're not the only one that we ask these questions to. These are the questions that we go through for everybody.
Right.
So, because sometimes they can feel like, "Well, why is she all up in my business?"
Yes.
We also, in talking yesterday, talked about the act of having that resting, what did I call it? Resting peaceful
face? Resting peaceful face.
Yes, resting peaceful,
peaceful face. Yeah.
Face. And I mean, that can be hard because sometimes you don't always believe what they're telling you.
Yeah.
And you can't show it.
Right. Yeah. And that's another thing as far as gestures, because, you know, applicants coming in and they're coming for the interview. So, of course, you know, sometimes they dress the part. You know, sometimes they look really nice. They may have jewelry. They may drive a nice car. And, you know, the manager's looking out the window and saying, "Now, I know she's not going to drive up in here and think, you know, and she needs housing." But you can't let what you're thinking on the inside show on, you know, on the outside, because we have to treat everyone fair and we can't judge them just based on their appearance. So we have to be careful about those facial expressions.
Don't be judgy.
Yeah.
So
I like that. Don't be judgy.
Don't be judgy.
Yeah.
I worked in TV for about 20 years and I used to go and practice my resting peaceful face. And you have to just go look in the mirror and I mean, take a good look at yourself. See what you're doing, and then also maybe ask for a critique from a colleague. Is there something I can improve on? Do you notice things that I do that may turn the residents off? Just to get that self-check. That's hard to do. Because not everybody wants to hear about themselves.
Yeah, but that's a really good point. That's probably something all of us need to do.
Now, sometimes, you know, I always say the biggest thing you want to do when you're interviewing somebody, whether you're a reporter or a manager on a property, is to make people feel at ease. Sometimes people want to do that by being touchy-feely. But in a housing situation, that's probably not the best thing to do.
Not until you get a read on that person. Because if the applicant is coming in for the interview and they're like, "Good morning," you need to reciprocate that, because they let you know that they are touchy-feely. Because I'm touchy-feely. But I have to read people to make sure that they're touchy, touchy-feely. And I think one of the most important things that we can do is understand that you are welcoming someone to your home. You are the property manager. You are responsible for that property. It's just like your home. So when you welcome someone to your home, your arms are open. Come on in. Come on in. Have a seat. And you're smiling because you're glad to see them. Because just as they need a good place to live, you need a good resident. So welcome them to your home. Make them feel that this is the place they need to be. And this is the beginning. Your goal is to stay leased up. Mm-hmm. And if they like that warm feeling and you make them feel like this is a great place to be, they will tell their friends, mm-hmm. you know, hey, you need to go down to that community because she was so nice when I went in there. The interview process was awesome.
Open body language.
Open. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Open. Palms up.
Because if you start the process off on a good foot, it's going to make them feel at ease. It's going to make them. Uh-oh. Our connection got hung up for a sec, though. So, just try to make them feel at ease so that you can ask the right questions and get the right answers.
Right.
And if they do look confused, ask them or just let them know, hey.
Yeah. And managers are really good at what they do. They know the questions on the questionnaire. They're going to get the biggest response mm-hmm. or question about or hesitation to provide. They know what information that applicant is going to be like, should I say yes or should I say no? Mm-hmm. So they will know. They will know when they're looking at them. They'll know what they're hung up on.
So let's say you're asking a question and you're confused about an answer. Can you show that in your face? Or?
Yeah. As the manager doing the interview mm-hmm. or me?
As a manager doing the interview.
You can, but you can do it in a pleasant way. Mm-hmm. Because if you're looking at it, you're going over the application, you can say, I'm looking at this. Are you sure? Is this the correct answer?
With a smile.
You know, with a smile. Always with a smile. A smile will get them every time. Mm-hmm. Just, are you sure this is the correct answer? Are these all the household members? Mm-hmm. And just smile when you're doing it so you're not interrogating mm-hmm. or they don't feel like you're interrogating them. You're having a conversation and you're gathering information.
Yeah.
That's how you want them to feel. This is a conversation that we have to have mm-hmm. because we have to gather the information.
That's good.
You just do it with a smile.
Do it with a smile. You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Right. No,
right.
You're not.
No. Do any of you have any questions as far as body language? If you do, go ahead and there we go. If you have any questions, just go ahead and write them down. We always hear about sitting back with your arms crossed. Which I would think that an applicant would be more likely to do that than a manager, unless it's just me.
It depends on the type of day the manager is having.
I'm sure a lot of you can understand that.
This is just one of those days. You know, you don't know how many calls they've gotten. You don't know if they were, you know, up all night trying to, you know, move residents to another mm-hmm. floor due to incidents. So, you know, the applicant may come in and get one of these.
Yeah.
You know, but as managers, we have to be conscious of that. We have to be conscious of, making sure that we remain open and we remain receptive. And it really is hard. It really is a challenge, especially with everything that's going on in the world. I'm sure lately, everyone's coming to work just in a, you know, mm-hmm. not in their normal spirit of, mm-hmm. you know. So it's even harder now.
Yeah, it is.
So we have to put forth more effort because we still have to do our job. Mm-hmm. You know, our prayers are with everyone that's struggling and having these difficulties right now and are grieving. Our prayers are with them, but we still have to continue to pray and do what we can for them and do what we can to help our applicants. So it's more of a challenge to make sure we're keeping that open and willingness to help and calm and friendly face with a smile.
And especially now with so many natural disasters that have happened as of late, you may get.
You are swamped when you are stressed, when you've got a serious maintenance issue mm-hmm. going on. You know, it's hard to put on a smile when you're in the midst of trying to resolve a chaos. So set aside a day mm-hmm. and dedicate that time to your applicant so you can be thorough, you can be in a good place,
yes.
you know, where you're ready to take the time to get all the information from them that you need. You're not feeling rushed, you're not feeling pressured. Mm-hmm. So set aside a day to do that. I think you're more productive that way.
Good. Good. So that's a good idea, because then you can get your mind right.
Yes. Opposed to talking to them and not talking to them. You know mm-hmm. how we do that sometimes when mm-hmm. we've got a million things going on in our head, mm-hmm. but we're supposed to be doing this, but your mind is up on 11th floor wondering if the Mason's guy uh-huh. got the mold out the bathroom, but still, okay, you live where last? Uh-huh. You know, so you really need to set aside time.
Just going through the motions.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So get your mind right. Fix your face.
Yes. The calm, what did you call it?
The resting.
Resting.
Peaceful face.
Peaceful face.
Yes. Just, you know, we're friendly here.
Yeah.
And we want you to come live with us if you qualify.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you qualify, we want you to come live with
us. Because we need you. Like you need us.
Yeah. So any other tips that you can think of? We covered not being too touchy-feely. Yeah. Unless the person is open and warm and a huggy person.
Yeah. Keep in mind when they walk in your door, treat them like they are walking into your home.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they are a guest.
Open palms.
Open palms.
No pointing.
No rolling eyes.
Oh.
You know, we roll our eyes sometimes mm-hmm. because we're like, oh, gosh.
Yeah.
So let's not do that.
Eyes. And the pursing of the lips. My husband calls me Percy because I'm good at pursing.
Yeah.
Like, really?
Yeah, really.
And you may be thinking that, but you can't say it.
Yeah.
Cannot say
That's a big thing around here, too. Think it.
Uh-huh.
Don't say it.
Think it.
You
don't say it.
But don't say it. Just smile and keep going.
Smile and keep going. So, any questions? We have about 7 minutes left. If you do have questions, just go ahead and type them in. Hey, Natoya, thank you. She says, looking good, ladies. Great job. Thank you.
Hi, Toya.
We appreciate it.
Miss you.
We've had trouble with our connection today.
Yeah.
It worked out. We have 6 minutes left. I don't really have anything else to talk about. Oh yeah, we did want to say this though. If you have ideas for Tuesday tips, please send them our way. My email address is ehall@navigatehousing.com. That's ehall@navigatehousing.com. Because this series is wrapped up and we haven't shot anything for next week. So if you have ideas.
She's like, help us, please.
Please do. We really want to hear from you because we want to answer the questions and the topics that you're having trouble with.
Yeah.
So that we can be timely and really be of service to you guys.
Yeah. This is for you all. So mm-hmm. It's not for us.
Yeah.
Definitely not for me because, you know, I'm not the camera person.
Oh, yeah. So, thank you, Burnell.
So this is all for you all. So, again, if there's any topics you all want Edna and Vicky to cover.
Or Burnell.
Please contact them and let them know so they can put that together for you.
But thank
Just
you, Burnell. Because this was short notice.
You're very welcome.
She found out yesterday that she's going to be doing this with me.
You're very welcome.
And I appreciate
good stuff.
It.
Good stuff. I'm glad you all do this.
Yeah, and I'm glad that it's you really have come into the fold. It's gonna be great.
You're so welcome. Thank you.
You see her body language?
Did y'all see that?
That was pretty good, right?
Okay. Some of those not to do. You're mm-hmm. so welcome, Evan. Thank you for having me.
Well, you know, and speaking of that, we don't want to be too fake because then people can read that.
Yeah.
And then be like,
yeah, oh. Nice, nasty. Don't be nice.
Yeah. I'm like, this heifer for real.
Yeah, yeah.
So
let's not be nice, nasty.
No,
we don't like that.
Let's be genuine.
A genuine smile.
Yeah.
Genuine welcome mm-hmm. to your community.
And I guess sometimes
keep it real.
They say if you can't do that, then maybe you should be using something else on property.
Right. Yeah.
Because that's very important.
It is.
The interview process and making people feel at home. And that's great. Who's this? Oh, Natoya. Okay. If a manager is in a meeting with an applicant and is interrupted by a resident, how would they address the applicant? That's a good question.
That is. You're in the middle of an interview.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a good question. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Because sometimes you do get interrupted.
Yeah.
And you're like, what?
Yeah.
You don't want to do
that. Didn't you see that sign on the door?
This is an interview's in progress. Don't come in here.
Yeah.
Don't want to do that. That's
and you don't want to give them that look like, don't do that. That's a bad look. Because you're looking at them like, why? Why did you come here and do the sign?
Can't you see I'm busy?
Yeah.
While you may think it, don't say it. Don't let it show on your face.
I can say, be with you in just a moment.
Yes. Okay. I think that about wraps it up this week. We appreciate you. And send your Tuesday tip ideas to ehall@navigatehousing.com. That's ehall@navigatehousing.com. We really appreciate you joining us today. And we'll see you next week with another Tuesday tip.
Thank you. Y'all take care. Have a great day.
Bye.